What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading to Windows 11 22H2 using SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so today's video is all about upgrading to Windows 11 22H2 using Configuration Manager. Now, I have a Windows 11 machine already within my infrastructure, but it's running an old build, and I want to upgrade it to the latest build. So this is the machine that I'm going to hit, and the first thing that we need to do within our configuration manager is we need to go inside administration. Within administration, we are going to go to overview, go to site configuration, click on sites, and select your site. Now from here, we're going to right click on our site. We're going to pick configure site components, and then we are going to pick software update point. On here, we're going to go inside classifications and make sure you have upgrades checked off. The next thing that we need to do is go to products and then go all the way to the bottom and locate Windows 11. Make sure you have that checked off. And the reason that you need those two things because you want Windows 11 upgrade packages to be synced within your SCCM. At the time that I was actually doing this, Windows 11 upgrade packages wasn't fully synced to my configuration manager, and I wasn't able to see build 22H2 within my configuration manager. But don't freak out because it's the same approach. All right, it's the same thing. Once you make those modifications, click OK here. We're going to go into client settings, and within client settings, we are going to pick default client settings. So we're going to right click on that, go to properties. On your left hand side, we're going to go into software updates. On your right hand side, we're going to go all the way to the bottom until we see these two following settings that we need to configure. The first one is specify thread for feature updates. By default, it is configured to not configured. So we are going to click on the drop down menu and then pick on normal. Now the last setting that we need to configure is enable dynamic updates for feature updates. Click on the drop down menu and then click on yes, and then click OK. Now within your configuration manager, we're going to go inside software, overview, we're going to open up your Windows servicing and then click on all Windows feature updates. Now within this section, again, go to the search bar, type in 22H2 and hit on the search button, and it should populate the build for 22H2. Again, my configuration manager was acting up at this time. It did not sync all the Windows 11 upgrade stuff, but it's the same process. I was able to locate upgrade to Windows 11 edition, but this is the same process. And once you locate your 22H2 build, you're going to select it and we're going to right click on it. The first thing that we need to do is select review license and just accept the license and terms and then click OK. Once you do that, locate your build that you want to deploy and right click on that. And we are going to click on download. Within the download software updates wizard, we are going to pick create a new deployment package. We're going to give it a name, and then you're going to give it a UNC path. This is what I gave it. And then we're going to click on next. We're going to click on add. We're going to pick DP. We're going to select our DP and we're going to click on OK. We're going to click next here. For our distribution settings, I left everything as is. I clicked next here. For download, I just make sure download software updates from the internet was selected. By default, it is. So click next here. For update languages for the product, I left everything as the default. Click next. A nice little summary. Click next. And then you're going to get a progress bar. If you want to check the status of this, just go inside the UNC path and make sure you get a folder. Most likely you get a folder with a gibberish name. If you double click on it, you're going to see an exe file, and this is it. Now, this exe file is between around 1.5 to 2 gigs. It's pretty big, so it will take some time for it to download locally to your configuration manager server. Once that's done, you're going to get this. Green check marks is always a good thing when you're dealing with configuration manager. That's how I feel. And then click on close. Now, once you do that, we're going to locate our feature update. We're going to select it. We're going to right click on it and we're going to pick on deploy. Once you pick on deploy, you're going to give your deployment a name. It's up to you, whatever you want. This is what I gave it. I'm going to click on browse to select a collection. I'm going to pick my selection, which is Windows 11, because again, I'm upgrading my Windows 11 machines to a new build. That's what I want to do within Configuration Manager. Once you pick your collection, we're going to click OK. We're going to click Next here. For the deployment settings, I left everything as the default. Click Next. For scheduling, I just made sure within the installation deadline, I picked as soon as possible, and then I click Next. For the user experience, underneath the deadline behavior, I just checked off these two options, software updates installation, and a system restart if necessary, and then I clicked on Next. For alerts, I didn't do anything, default, Next here. For the download settings, within the download option, I made sure that I selected download software updates from the DP and installed, and I also made sure that I picked if the software updates are not available on your DP, it's able to go and download it locally on the Microsoft Update server. So I click Next here. You're going to get a nice little summary. Click Next. Green check marks, always a good thing, and then you're able to close it. Now, you're able to go inside your deployment packages, and you should see your new deployment package. Just make sure on the right-hand side where it says distribution point status, it's green, it's successful, it's a good thing, awesome. The next thing you could do is go inside the Monitor tab, Deployments, and then locate your deployment. Double-click on your deployment, and within the deployment status, you're going to see, hopefully, it should show up that your computers are compliant. For me, that V Windows 11 machine is compliant, and eventually it's going to get the deployment, the upgrade for it to push out, and it will upgrade using SCCM. So how awesome is that? So hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.